My name is Dinesh. I work for a company called Electronic Arts, EA Games, as a workplace manager, and I'm part of FMC Group, the Facilities Management Council. So my question here is like, you have a great vision, and the government has a great vision. But the government, like if you see the systems of government in addressing any challenges, like there is no sustainability. So if we come like, if it is Swachh Bharat or Haritaharam or the footpaths, so we just see the traction for a month when all the news channels, all the officials just come. After a month, again, we just see it just deep down. So like, we don't see any traction over it over a point of time. So like, what is your vision in coming? I think like how you have come up with T-Hub by a lot of brainstorming. So will there, should I think, do we revisit all our processes and come up with very sustainable models, or there should be government bodies which should continuously monitor for sustainable practices?
A great question, Dinesh. Thank you. In fact, a lot of times there is an initial outburst of enthusiasm which cannot be sustained later is the question. A lot of good initiatives, a lot of, you know, well thought out, meaningful initiatives which don't typically last or deliver because the outcome is never really monitored or, you know, sustained. Great question. There are two things we can do. One, an initiative like Haritaharam, for example, or Swachh Bharat, because you mentioned both of them. See, Swachh Bharat, you see, when Prime Minister Modi launched it, and when he initially started sweeping also, you know, just as a photo op, sweeping the road, just to demonstrate that even the Prime Minister is doing it, you also need to get involved. The intent, or when the Chief Minister does it, the intent is not that Prime Minister is going to sweep or Chief Minister is going to sweep your roads every day. The intent is for people to get, the message is for people to get, that even a man like Prime Minister is focused on this, so we might as well start acting on our own and start, you know, doing something every single day. A lot of times in India, community participation is a huge challenge. Sustained community participation is even a bigger challenge. You know, there is that initial outburst of enthusiasm. When we started Haritaharam, a lot of organizations came forward, they said, sir, we'll plant. Yes, you did. But what after? Now, I can't go around and, you know, water every single sapling that has been planted. 100 crore saplings have been planted. It is our individual social responsibility as well. You know, people talk about corporate social responsibility, CSR. There is ISR also, individual social responsibility of not littering, of keeping our streets clean, watering the plants that we've planted, etc., etc. So, for this to sustain, there has to be a lot of public participation, for one, a lot of volunteerism, you know, so to put. Secondly, even a government needs to start monitoring its goals, its objectives. We've done that in Mission Kakatiya. That's why you see the results. So we've broken it into five phases. 20,000, you know, tanks have been completed, like I pointed out. But there are 26,000 more to go. So we broke that into three more windows, three more phases. And we are going after them aggressively also. Now, Haritaharam or Swachh Bharat, unless people participate along with government, things will not change and things will not see the outcomes we all want. But ultimately, you know, when it comes to taking tough calls, it becomes a huge challenge for government. When my daughter was five, I took her to Singapore, you know, on a holiday. I told her the day she landed there that if you start littering, you know, in Singapore, you'll be jailed. She was shocked. She said, really? I said, yes. For next 1 week, we were there. She did not litter. She was very, very well behaved. But as soon as she came back to India, back to normal. Point I'm trying to make is, Indians, I'm not just pointing out to any one of us, including myself. I'm not, you know, different from any of you. We are, hamare yahan ek attitude hai, chalta hai. Kuch nahi hoga, chalta hai. Go in the wrong route, chalta hai. Jump the signal, chalta hai. Jump the, you know, get onto the zebra crossing, chalta hai. We have that attitude. And then this very gentleman or this very lady, when she's driving in the West, or in another country, is extremely well behaved, is extremely law abiding. There is something yahan pe pani mein kuch gadbad hai, which makes us, you know, take it for granted, take our freedom for granted. So maybe, you know, when it comes to taking some tough calls, you know, when that movie came out, Mahesh Babu's, a lot of people asked me, why don't you start fining people, you know, imposing heavy fines on people who violate traffic rules? Easier said than done, trust me. Itna aasan nahi hai. So I told Mahesh also the same thing. I said, easy hai, movie mein bata diya easy hai, real life not so easy. Even Mahesh would not like it if I start finding him way too much, you know. So Point is, for sustained outcomes of good initiatives, we need larger participation from the public and at the same time, a more focused approach from the government.